Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the channel once again. Welcome to the delayed flight. Let us make it short so we will not board inside our plane. The problems with crashes after the updates of Microsoft Flight Simulator, they didn't stop. Actually, they got even worse. So here are a few things that I would like to share with you in order to recover. There is another clip that I posted not a long time ago. It was after the previous update. The last one, I think it is SU11, isn't it? So I will repeat a few things that I said also to the previous clip, that the preparation starts before the installation. Let us not go to the community folder. Find your community folder. I have showed those things lots of times, so I think that you are able to find your community folder. Before the installation, put everything outside. For instance, if you see here, most of my content in the community folder is outside now, and afterwards you proceed to the installation. This is number one. Now, number two is a trick which is quite helpful, so please be attentive. On this bar, you go to Task Manager, okay, and then you go to details here. Okay, you go to details. So this is quite interesting. You find your Microsoft Flight Simulator, not letter M, but here F. Here it is. So right click, and then you go set priority. This here. So here are actually all the programs, okay? And when you turn on your PC, somehow all those programs are working, seems, okay? I'm not a specialist to those things, okay? But this is something that can be quite helpful. So, priorities. Priorities of MSFS 2020 is this only, okay? So, go here. Not properties, priorities, what am I doing? Okay, set priority, this one here. And you can change this one. From normal, you can go until high. Never go to real time. You can just destroy your computer with one click, okay? Go either above normal or high priority. And this might be quite helpful. Now, the only problem is that maybe you have to do this every time. I mean, for instance, now I have the simulator running. Here it is, isn't it? But somehow it is turned again back to normal priority. So maybe you have to do this every time. Have a try. Go to priority above normal and see if you see any difference. And then go to priority high, and if you are satisfied, you can as well somehow keep this change. Okay, and then you go apply. I will not change this now, but anyhow, afterwards you press the apply button. The other thing has to do with this DLSS. DLSS is not for everyone. Maybe you have seen lots of clips about it, this new feature, DLSS, or you watched on internet something. Have in mind that this is about the RTX NVIDIA cards. It is not below RTX, GTX or whatever. Actually, it is above RTX 2000. So if you go, let's say, here, to General Options, here it must be, this NVIDIA DLSS and so on. I don't know even if sometimes maybe you can even change the settings, but please don't attempt this one. Don't go here. Maybe it is not even possible. Maybe the system recognizes which one is your NVIDIA cards and you cannot change it. But anyhow, this, if you don't have an NVIDIA card above 2000 and RTX NVIDIA card, so please don't attempt this. You will make things worse and you can have easier a crash. So here you can see, this is from NVIDIA site, which cards benefits DLSS 2, and about DLSS 3, I think it is the new RTX NVIDIA cards above 4000, the last ones. Okay, that was the first thing that I wanted to show you to show to you. Actually, the second after the change of the priority settings of MSFS 2020. And the second one is this one here. Okay, here it is clearly written. This is also from the NVIDIA site. DLSS 3 technology is supported on GeForce RTX 40 series. This means above 4000. So don't play with these things much. Here we are in MSFS forum. And now we go to the point, and the point is DirectX 11 or DirectX 12. Actually, my previous clip, it was about this. In the forum, it is clearly written that DirectX 12 is experimental. I mean, what else do you want to see? Here it is. DirectX 11 is officially supported. DirectX 12 is beta and still is experimental. So, here you will proceed at your own risk. The only way to go back to the game, experimental or not, after the crash, I restarted the MSFS 20. I restarted the simulator with DirectX 12. Yes, but afterwards, it is more wise to go back to DirectX 11 because this is which is supported. Now, if you go to Google and you type DirectX 12 crash, you see that there are lots of results, actually. I mean, there are so many games that DirectX can destroy them. So please be careful about this, because if you have a crash and you see this one here, isn't it? Better, I wish you not to see this one. So if you have a crash, the only way to go back to the game is with a safe mode, isn't it? Don't lose your time. I have done this. There were some weekends that I was trying to go back to the game with a normal mode. Don't attempt. Start the game with safe mode. Go to your settings, change to DirectX 12, restart the game, and to return to DirectX 11. I'm saying those things because maybe, I don't know, I saw my previous clip and somehow I think that the idea was to keep DirectX 12. No, no, this is not the idea. Go back to DirectX 11. And actually, when I recorded the previous clip, there was another coincidence that NVIDIA was updating the cards. And this update of NVIDIA, at the same time we had the update of NVIDIA cards and the previous update of Microsoft Flight Simulator, isn't it? That was a very bad combination, because the update of the NVIDIA cards, okay, those things, you know what to say. If you have the NVIDIA card, you go here, isn't it? It is something like this. Here, you go to drivers, you check for updates and so on, and you update. So that was a very bad combination. It was a very bad coincidence. The game was running with DirectX 11. NVIDIA updated the cards, and these updates were problematic. That was a very bad combination, because I had to update my card. And after a few days, there are announcements about this. Quite a lot on internet. Somehow the problem was fixed. And so my point is that now, if you see, I have the DirectX 11, which is more reliable. The other was a parachute, DirectX 12. I will not change it here. It was a parachute just to restore the computer. And afterwards, I changed this one. It can be the DirectX 12 is still experimental. It is not my field, and I cannot say for sure. Okay, I'm not a specialist. But definitely what I can say for sure is that DirectX 11 is tested. And if you change this and you go to DirectX 12, definitely you will lose frames. So if you don't want to change your settings a lot, because I also suggested that you should change your settings and reduce them. For instance, there are some guys that, okay, everything to ultra. Yes, it doesn't work like this. You can have a quick look at my settings. I showed them also another time, if this is important. This is somehow done after watching lots of clips in YouTube and reading lots of forums. It looks like this something. Have a look if it is interesting for you. Once again, you can pause the clip and you can have a look at my settings. So I think this is all for now. I just wanted to make clear that DirectX 11 is reliable. And if you have a crash, you follow those steps, you empty your community folder. Little by little, you put everything again inside. And actually the damage will not be from, let's say, deliveries. It will be from the programs, or it will be from the airplanes that you have installed. Deliveries in general, they don't cause any problems. So you restart MSFS 2020 in safe mode. You go DirectX 12. Okay, not to show you again those things. I have showed them already. Here it is, DirectX version. You log off, and then it seems that you will be able to restart the game normally. So go back here and change it to DirectX 11, which is the default one, and definitely it is more reliable. This is all for now. Thank you for watching this clip. If you find this advice helpful, please do subscribe and support the channel. And I hope to see you soon to the next one. Bye for now.